fans, I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Northwestern Wildcats and the DePaul Blue Demons. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
Hey, Brad, we should really pay attention to the matchup in the middle. These kids are really skilled and worth paying special attention to. Expect a big game for one, if not both of them.
Teams are ready to go, and we're ready for the tip. Well, here we go. Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Gave it up. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries to knock down the three. Nails the J. The Blue Demons are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
On the outside. Puts up the J. Missed it. The Wildcats set up in their zone motion. And a momentary look from three-point land. In the lane.
Excellent jump shot right there.
And a slam.
Dipsy dude, Dunkaroo, are you kidding me?
And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
It's a quick hitting offense that can be difficult to defend. The back cuts, the high post action, the screening. When these things are done well, look out.
And we'll get a change of possession. Let's take a moment and look at this dunk just one more time.
Hey, when you can finish above the rim, you've got nothing to worry about, my friend. You should always throw it down, and you have the chance.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Coach is trying to get the players to think defense now. Fed the low block.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
The Wildcats go into their zone motion now. Pull-up jumper, left side. The Wildcats are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, their stuff is absolutely dynamic. It is unbelievable the way they get those back cuts. They read so well the defense, and as soon as the defense doesn't see ball, you man, they got a layup.
Off the mark. Cross court. He shoots the jumper. Jumper won't go. He drains the shot. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
This guy's the total package. He can beat you in more ways than one, and that's scary for any defense.
Whistle blown. That's a backcourt infraction.
You can't make those kind of mistakes in games like these, Brad.
Check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, it's quite obvious that the coaching staff wants their team to slow down the tempo. I can hear him on the sideline talking to his bench players about...
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
So the inbound play on the baseline. It's not smart to just throw it out of bounds. They'll set it up from the baseline. Dumps it in. Fakes a jumper. Jumper off the mark. The Wildcats now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Rod. The zone motion offense creates...
Blocked! Can't connect. The Blue Demons set up into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading a side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Bust the J. Setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I tell you, look at the movement they're getting. Great backdoor cuts, tremendous use in a high post, great execution to the weak side.
Number 31 handles the pass, gets the J to fall. They work the perimeter. For two. Oh, yes. Looking for a good shot. He launches a three. He misses the fadeaway. Long receives the ball. Zone motion now. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Moving it around the perimeter. Let's it fly. Perfectly executed. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, Brad, that Princeton offense utilizes the high post exceptionally well. You cut off that high post, you get great motion, you make sure you have movement. The key to any offense is movement without the basketball. If you got movement without the basketball, you're going to get good shots. Coming inside.
There they are on the low block, on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Gave it up. Tries for two. It sticks. The Blue Demons will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defensive end. Other balanced teams may play in the half court offensively and really look to pressure their opponents in the full court.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. The missed shot. The Wildcats set up in their zone motion. Cross court. Goes up. They got it. Working it around the perimeter.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Brown inside. 10 on the shot clock. Missed the jumper. Goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
On the right side. He shoots from left of the circle. Perfectly executed. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Hey, the Princeton is a tough one to play against. There are a lot of reads and misdirection plays, which makes it a tough offense to defend.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Comes up empty.
That's basic.
From the top of the circle, missed it. Brown receives the ball into their zone motion now. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, it's obvious the coaching staff wants the team to slow it down. The tempo is definitely not where they want it. The players have been instructed to run the shot clock offensively and force the opposition to play defense for extended periods of time.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, Brad, the Princeton offense is based on a lot of motion, movement without the basketball. You got to really be able to cut and go to the goal.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. Nice shot.
Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
On the dribble, gives it up. About 6 minutes remaining. The small forward gets the pass. Trying to pack it inside. Turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. The Wildcats move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can.
Throws go. Number 35 set to record his first action.
Hey, this guy will give you a great hustle on the defensive end of the floor.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, man.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
They're working around the perimeter. He goes with a jump hook. Off the mark. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock.
Go, 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 go. Double team now, bad angle.
Off the mark.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Kane handles the pass. He throws it up from downtown. Nails the J. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Hey, it's a great system if all five guys are on the same page. It really forces you to work on defense. 50% of the time, it leaves the defense looking silly.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. We're at the 4-minute mark. The skip pass is picked off. The Wildcats now looking for a basket in transition. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The small forward with the ball. On the outside.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
In and out. Trying to feed inside. He goes up with it. Nails a sweet jumper. Inside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Looking for a good shot. There they come with a double team to stop it. He looks for three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They work it around the perimeter. The ball stripped. They work it around the perimeter. He tries the three. They get it to go.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two. Can't put it down. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Cross court. Here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
On the outside. For the bucket. He gets the bucket. If he's got a strong point, it's his ability to distribute the ball.
There's only one basketball out there, so you need guys who are willing to pass.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. He nails the shot. One minute left to go. For two, makes it. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball into the high post puts pressure on the defense.
The Wildcats have really been able to get it done here as a team today, Dick.
I tell you, if you're on the floor, that means your coach trusts you and believes you can play a role out there. Hey, we've seen some great plays from a number of different players so far, and that always makes things difficult for an opponent.
Running that Princeton offense here.
I tell you, look at the movement they're getting. Great backdoor cuts, tremendous use of the high post, great execution to the weak side.
Turnaround jumper. The missed shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. That was a great delivery on the back cut, Dick.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
They work the perimeter. Wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move. These teams have played each other tight, and at the end of the first half, they're even.
DePaul has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Number 44 checks back into the ballgame.
Yeah, I knew they couldn't leave him out for too long.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Looking for a good shot. Now with 10 to shoot. The glass and no good. Law receives the ball. The Wildcats go into their zone motion now. Cross court. Tries for two. He buries the shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Loose ball, kept in. The layup is good. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I tell you, that Princeton offense drives you bananas. Look at the way they spread the court. Tremendous spacing, great execution, and they read so exceptionally well. Any mistake the defense makes, it is absolutely layup time. Inside.
Here's a double team. Buries it. Turns it over. Working it around the perimeter. The Wildcats pushing the ball in transition. There's a double team waiting there. Gave it up. For the bucket. He can't get the bucket to fall. Zone offense now.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Buried it. Good cut, great pass right there.
It's great seeing those types of plays. That's team basketball.
Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, the Princeton is a tough one to play against. There are a lot of reads and misdirection plays, which makes it a tough offense to defend.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Number five picks up the foul. First team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
First shot is no good. The Wildcats here running their zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
The Wildcats got some good ball reversal there.
You know, Brad, when you move the ball like that, defenses get off balance and out of position.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There's a slam. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Well, the Princeton is a unique offense. The cuts back door are special, and they keep the defense off balance. It's a patient system that a lot of teams struggle to defend.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
And work it into a double team on a post. Change of possession. The Blue Demons have been getting it done with a number of players here, Dick.
When you have guys that want to win, you're going to get different players stepping up in different ways. When it's about the W, individual numbers aren't important.
Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, Brad, the Princeton offense is based on a lot of motion, movement without the basketball. You got to really be able to cut and go to the goal.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. They'll work it around the arc. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Entry pass in the paint. He hammers it home. Perimeter. Definitely a foul. The layup counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Rims out.
Nice rebound. Way to come out with the ball and push it up the court.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two. Off the glass and no good. The Wildcats now running a zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
And the slam. The dribble, gives it up. Control of the ball. Goaltending violation. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I'll tell you, Brad, that Princeton offense utilizes the high post exceptionally well. You cut off that high post, you get great motion, you make sure you have movement. The key to any offense is movement without the basketball. If you got movement without the basketball, you're going to get good shots.
10 to shoot. Drains the shot. Kane handles the pass.
There's the trap.
Knocked it down. The Blue Demons did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
Turner receives the pass.
Double team now, bad angle.
On the right side. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Kane handles the feed. Tries for two. Gets it to go. Picks off the lazy pass. On the outside. For the bucket. That was nice. Looking for a good shot. He tries the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Jumper won't go. The point guard takes the feed. The Wildcats now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Missed it. Now they work it around the perimeter. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the top of the key. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Brown handles the pass. Can't connect.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Scorches the net. Running that Princeton offense here.
Oh, that Princeton offense can drive you bananas. Look at the cuts to the goal. They spread the court, great spacing, great execution. 15 to 17 feet apart on each possession.
Change of possession. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
It's a quick hitting offense that can be difficult to defend. The back cuts, the high post action, the screening. When these things are done well, look out.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
Nope.
Pulls down the rebound. The Wildcats here running their zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
On the right side. Loose ball, great play. With the J. Off the mark.
Nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
About 6 minutes remaining. On the outside with a deep shot from outside. Scores it. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, look at the movement they're getting. Great backdoor cuts, tremendous use of the high post, great execution to the weak side.
Number 30 is charged with the foul. Second team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets it. He misses the second. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
Oh, yes, the student body, always full of comedy and excitement.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Puts up the jumper. He drains the jumper. 5 minutes left in the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards that they have.
Yeah, that helps. Zone offense now. They work the perimeter. Stolen ball. They get out on the break. For the deuce. Two with a lay-in. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I'll tell you, that Princeton offense drives you bananas. Look at the way they spread the court. Tremendous spacing, great execution, and they read so exceptionally well. Any mistake the defense makes, it is absolutely layup time.
Shot rejected. Now looking to attack. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion.
That's a basket off the break, baby.
Looking for a good shot. And the block. They move it into the front court. Great hustle. He shows the sweet touch. Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, it's a great system if all five guys are on the same page. It really forces you to work on defense. 50% of the time, it leaves the defense looking silly.
He up fakes. Goes up with it. Nails the J. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Moving it around the perimeter. About 3 minutes remaining. For two. Was that beautiful or what?
Inside.
He shoots the jumper. Oh, yes. There's a high screen.
Good job of stepping out on the screener.
The Blue Demons are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Working it around the perimeter. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the right side.
Look at that spacing.
Zone motion now. And he goes with a spin, swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The Blue Demons now looking for a basket in transition. Goes up for two. He couldn't get it to fall. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Number 30 is called for the foul. Let's check out this jumper one more time. Well, this This is not one of the better free throw shooting teams in college basketball, that's for sure.
I'll tell you, that's a bad characteristic to have. When you got guys that are brick city on the line, it makes the coach lose some hair, baby.
Makes his second shot. It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad.
About a minute remaining. He may be in some trouble here. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Hey, the Princeton is a tough one to play against. There are a lot of reads and misdirection plays, which makes it a tough offense to defend.
He blocks the shot. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
Good.
They need to score here to turn this into a one possession game.
Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Well, Dick, it really seems as though things are starting to heat up right now on the sidelines.
Hey, coaches hate to see their players underperform. Playing to their capabilities is important. He's going to stay on them all game to make sure everyone on the floor is playing as hard as they can play on every possession.
And we're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. It's a 5-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
He misses the J. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Reed steps to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
The Wildcats move into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
And before we go anywhere else, let's check in and look at our players of the game.
It was great to see these two kids get after it here today. It always makes the game more interesting when you have competitors like this playing on opposing teams.